Greetings to our WE family and friends. I'm glad to get to visit with you just for a moment and say thank you, thank you, thank you for your prayers that are going on with the prayers of others around the world for where we are. You know, we're blessed in our fellowship that we understand the significance of the prayer of agreement and touching those lives that go far beyond our personal reach. This organization absolutely is represented globally. And this pandemic, it's wrapped itself around the world. So we are praying for our world. Thank you for praying for the world. Let me just tell you, I know you know the portion of scripture in 1 Chronicles, but I was reading it the other day about there were a people, the people of Issachar, who knew the signs of the time, and they were able to make the decisions that were good for the people of Israel about their future. I'm praying that God will give you a good word on what the future looks like for you and your ministry. Now, with that, I want to offer a caution. There are many people that we're being, all of us, being inundated with what they believe God is saying to us that we're supposed to do. Some of it you need to take with a grain of salt, because we are to discern, is this right? Is this biblical? Is it for me? What is it? If it's fear-based, if it's anti-church, I dismiss it. I just don't go there. But I want to exalt the name of Jesus in the midst of this and have the anticipation that the church that is stronger than the gates of hell will prevail and great things will happen. The one thing I do want to say about the future is this. We have a lot of people that are saying, I'm looking for God to do a new thing. Well, I had a conversation with someone the other day, and it became very clear to me that the reason they wanted something new to come out of this for them is because they didn't want to revisit the things that were undone that God had told them to do before. And it's kind of like an escape hatch. Let's go to the newest thing. You know, it's like the young guy that doesn't know how to keep his books, so the best way he knows how to do it is just close out his account at one bank and go open an account at a new bank. And the same problem is going to follow if. Now, I'm preaching, didn't mean to do that. But I think it's interesting that we have an opportunity to say, Lord, let me in my private sanctuary with you hear a clear word on how I can accomplish the things you have asked me to do, so that I can go on to hear the things that you want for me to do in the future. I've got some unfinished business to do. I've got some things I need to take care of in my own life from the past before this pandemic. And I want to continue, but I don't want to run away from it. So if that means anything to some of you, so be it. If not, I wouldn't worry so much about the future as I would concentrate on, God, help me to have your grace to finish what you've called me to do here and now. I want to finish strong. It was Eugene Peterson who wrote the book, and it's a quote from someone else that he got a hold of, a long obedience in the same direction. That's what God's calling us to, I believe. There's a lot of good going on, a lot of good words out there, a lot of good things being said, but I would say pray about all of it. And don't just take everything someone offers as this is thus saith the Lord and what we are supposed to do. No, let's pray about all things and rejoice, 1 Thessalonians, in all things and see what God will do. I sure love you. I'm for you. And if you need us, please don't hesitate to let us know. We've had some on the foreign fields that have let us know the situation they're in, and we're doing our best to resource with others and to help them as much as possible. We love you. We care about you. And the church is triumphant and will be triumphant in all that's going on. Praise God.